Next is Comisión Mexicana de Defensa y Promoción de los Derechos Humanos. You have the floor.
Señor Presidente.
Mr. President, we'd like to thank the Special Rapporteur on Minority Issues for his first report. I'm an indigenous human rights defender from Mexico who supports an indigenous minority group in the Huasteca region. Because of my defense work, I've been persecuted, criminalized, tortured, and imprisoned by elements of the Mexican armed forces. In spite of the fact that I was proven innocent by the Mexican authorities, I'm still facing risk in my country. In my work as a defender of indigenous communities, I've seen that we are constantly overlooked through policies of exclusion and discrimination. When private investment projects are implemented, our customs are trampled upon. Human rights defenders of minorities, particularly indigenous people, run a great risk. Mexican authorities have failed to provide a safe environment to defend our human rights, and we are concerned that they are pursuing a campaign of criminalization of victims, particularly of torture. We have been disgraced and re-victimized because we were survivors of torture, and we've also been branded as delinquents or defenders of criminals. Indigenous human rights defenders are concerned at the persistence on the part of the Mexican government to militarize public security. The abuses committed against me and my colleagues at the hands of the military are an example of how no democratic state should empower the military to exercise public security tasks. As in my case, many atrocious crimes committed in Mexico against minority groups continue to enjoy impunity. Therefore, we would call upon the international community of this council to support Mexico to establish an international mechanism against impunity that is made up of international persons who are independent and autonomous. Thank you.